that students can take in several universities of Taiwan. The Thai Ministry of Education also established the General English Proficiency Test as a method of preparing for Taiwanese for global society. As you can see, the government of Taiwan anticipates that Taiwanese officials, businessmen, educators, etc. will be able to join global organizations and exchange ideas in fluent English. From financial aspect, Taiwan has upgraded to one of the fully developed countries because Taiwanese have completed a great deal of international trade and conducted countless charity conventions. Therefore, more knowledge is required. Taiwan's prestigious scholars, including Nobel Prize winner Dr. Li Yuanzhe, are worried about Taiwan not making further economic progress easily because of its lack of energy resources and also because the lack of vaccine that released from the richer nations. At the Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation meeting on October 22, 2002, Dr. Li represented Taiwan and said that oil supplies will run out within 40 years. If the current supply and demand only depends on oil countries, further knowledge development through global communication is necessary and is significant. Additionally, as it can be inferred from the listing of conference participants, that the attending scientists, officials, and scholars from different nations uses English to analyze global problems. For instance, the energy crisis is not only a problem for Taiwan, but also a major problem for many Asian and the Pacific nations. One nation's destiny is related to each other. Substantively, the world is seen as an interrelated system in which technological, ecological, medical, economic, political, and development issues can be no longer be effectively addressed by individual nations because the issue become global, become only one, as they spill over all borders and the regions. As you can see, this world has become a very smaller global village. From view of example of Taiwan and our global village, besides the energy crisis affecting Taiwan, one other factor is technology. From a long-term perspective, if Taiwan old-fashioned productions cannot operate it and transform into more advanced technology classes such as computer industries, environmental protection, chemistry companies, or semiconductor industries, sooner or later, Taiwan cannot compete with the other industrialization nations that produce vaccine. Beyond doubt, Taiwan economy cannot improve smoothly and rapidly as it did 20 years ago. Because Taiwan has been established into developing country, mainly dependent on its low-cost labor force from South Asia. Unfortunately, they also caused lots of problems. The global low-cost laboring resource can be sufficiently and inexpensively offered from mainland China and Southeast Asia. It is a big problem. They also caused a lot of problems that only policemen know. As a result, many products for daily use once made in Taiwan 10 years ago are now most made in other countries. In reality, Taiwan is just a tiny island, which lacks natural resources and depends on imported materials. Therefore, how Taiwan can survive in this competitive global village with limited vaccine is to develop high-tech industry of medicine should be the only way to do. That is, do the vaccine by DIY. Then it will be competitive compared with other wealthy or highly industrialization countries. Knowledge from international communication will strengthen Taiwan's economy. If Taiwan has language ability, foreign employers and employees from all over the world would be much more willing to bring their technologies and skill to cooperate with Taiwanese companies, which assist Taiwan to produce high technology commodities such as laptops and cars and vaccines. These are fashionable products that can be exported to other countries too, to help the others, which can increase Taiwan's foreign income and also help the others. Indeed, cooperation between Taiwanese and the foreign companies in Hsinchu Science Park, Eastern Silicon Valley, has shown that there is an imperative necessity for students majoring in businesses, science and technology to receive training in English and be aware of the concept of globalization. From the view of English teachers, one pedagogy most teachers should use is to resolve the global problems cooperative with their students. Universal EFL teachers should facilitate understanding and solve problems using the wisdom of their students. In this way, they can contribute to solve issues caused by rapid globalization, raising by students' worldwide awareness in English. For university students who are interested in global science, chemistry, and physics, the curriculum and pedagogy designers should offer them topics like global warming and the changing climate and the COVID-19. From a stimulating story of the polar bear's population decreasing, a teacher should make the student aware about how much effort and money they have to compensate for using machines that release carbon dioxide. Furthermore, for university students who are interested in intercontinental relationships and those who whose major is social science, we can offer them topics like peace or conflict in Middle East. The peace and conflict between China and America. The globalization inspires students to think about these problems. From an unbiased angle, teachers should let students learn the truths and exchange information that they find from different mass media. For example, they can receive information from different types of media. In the same logic, university students who are interested in financial system and who major in business management can become more skilled at the topic such as energy crisis, environmental degradation caused by industrialization, poor and rich gap, import or export of energy and materials. Since these issues are closely related to world financial trends, students have to be familiar with the current information, especially the COVID-19 problem and where to get the vaccine, and be able to apply and discuss concept of global institution. For instance, university students can explore issues such as a world society safety net, resource like food and water in a poor corner of an undeveloped country. Additional issues can be increasing business cooperation opportunities with countries that are less wealthy than Taiwan, upgrading their national incomes, and the nutritional, educational, and the health care level. Science students can deepen their knowledge by discussing with teachers and classmates about topics like global warming, like COVID-19, like AIDS, like how to handle the endangered animals. The solution for forest, grassland, and dryland. So the student can be stimulated to resolve a certain catastrophe that they think is vital for human beings. For instance, a Down student may be aware of AIDS. There are more and more invisible AIDS worldwide. They might be willing to take an effort to keep people from human immunodeficiency virus infections that is never be cured by any types of medicine. Moreover, through the EFL materials found on the website of WHO and the resource of AIDS from libraries and bookstores, the students of specific science majors can learn how to transmit information to their friends or submit paper to global health institutions such as World AIDS Campaign and International Treatment Access Coalition. Through globalization education concepts, students can learn global common sense and protect themselves and communicate those ideas with others around them. Our large-scale problems are mostly caused by industrialization world injustice and conflict existing in human beings. The EFL teachers can solve these arduous global problems is facing them and finding cooperative approaches among countries. As EF teachers, we should assume global topics are inescapable and inevitable because they endow university students with common sense in such a globalized world and enable them to contribute to solving these universal problems and crises. If an English teacher wants to contribute to globalization, a question might appear. How do we choose appropriate topic for language learners? For example, the most important contextual factors are teachers' belief, values, practice, their acquaintance with globalization source to teach it. How do their students feel? And their perception of students' characteristic. If they match, EFL teachers must constantly strive to be updated, current, and knowledgeable in order to coach students in global topic. In other words, EFL teachers have to build up their familiarity of natural science, economics, and social science because universal topic engage with so many distinct yet interconnected fields. To bring this chapter to close with a question, what are the faculties of education doing to prepare future teachers to respond to crisis in the world, especially for the lack of vaccine? EFL teachers are accountable to stimulate and inspire and educate their students to produce it. And the tutor should make them feel capable in this universal community and give them some confidence. After all, the aim of EF construction is to train people to become improved human beings and communicate in order to function peacefully and efficiently in the up-to-the-minute world. The challenge, consequently, is on both teachers and students in university English classrooms. Through readings, through role play, through collaboration in lab, and with resource in the community, teachers and students should both develop their abilities to reflect upon the reasons for the controversies over global education and the providing approaches to resolve such conflicts. This study has been done a long time ago. For this project, researchers cooperate with students at two private universities and technological community and university. One of the researchers is an American professor at the private university who is a native speaker of English from United States. The second researcher who teaches the latter two school is a non-native speaker who studied in the USA for 7 years. They apply combined qualitative and quantitative empirical methods in order to add overall significance to design of the project. In other words, triangulation were conducted to raise the reliability and accuracy for the result retrieved, and therefore improving 1630. The state of present curriculum. In English course, survey question and interview were conducted. 372 students cooperated with the research. Most of them are from Taichung and Zhanghua and Yunlin. And there are majors of management and agriculture manage and the arts and humanities college. Most students support the private university to take this required course. This different school has different types of graduation for TOEIC scores. The students were from college engineering and the aeronautical engineering in the student of Yunlin. And the materials of learning are freely provided to the student from public domain. The content of the textbook include polar bear swimming and the disappearing Taiwan claw labor and do we should eat shark fin, etc. So the American teacher created the webpage so that the student could spend their own time learning and exploring the global society issues such as those related to stray dogs and cats, and also human rights. As a result, most students support this kind of humanized research. That is, the data collection is humanized after signing the IRB documents. And their data has been uploaded to SurveyMonkey for the teachers to do the transcribing and to do the theme dividing. The participants were assigned by different subtopics interact and the critic based on their expertise and the interest. They provide their knowledge toward the globalization. Most of them support the globalization can resolve the human common problems. I think this is my presentation for the May 24th.